Okay, so on the outskirts of the normal map is the Big Nothing, and you might think that there's nothing there, but actually, if you explore some of these areas, whilst it's very dangerous to do so because you can die almost instantly if you stray too far, there are things you can find. Now, I'm going to run through a few of them in this video. I might cut the video out at points to save on just moving around time. Now, the first and most obvious is right at the beginning of the game, where I currently am at this location. There's also some interesting stuff up in this little bit, including a whole sort of dungeon, as it were. There's some other stuff over here that I'm aware of, and I don't know about the rest yet. I'm going to look it up, see if I can find anything, and might have a little explore around. But for now, let's explore around the bottom of the map here. Let's see if there's anything here.
Stay put.
Aye, aye.
You're very tired out.
I'm here with my life.
So these locations that are in the Big Nothing, because they're not counted in the main game, it won't tell you how much stuff is here. You just have to guess whether or not you've got everything from the location. Some of the locations you can find are quite simple, like this one, and other ones are really quite complicated, like the one up in the east of the map that we'll explore later. I wish you could put the weapons in the back of your car. Awesome.
The wrong way.
So if you go too far out into the Big Nothing, then you start getting storms that damage you very severely, to the point where you will die almost instantly. Unless, of course, you've got a mod on that prevents that. PC, that is. Now there are areas like here where you can just instantly die by dropping off the map, which is obviously not something that I want to do.
Please, in this place of heat and dust, drain the very water out of her precious radiator!
Up there is where you first met Gripper. Right behind that mountain is the first base that we took.
Ah!
helicopter. Oh yeah, what I was saying before wasn't my first map record, it was actually where I started the game. Okay, we're back on the main map, but I'm back on the main map. There's your first place. So up here's a nice safe area to enter the Big Nothing to the east. So at this point we're right here, and we're going to drive up to here, and then to here. I'll go wherever I want, thank you. I'll go there. If you want to stay right. Okay, so this is my location. Okay, it might look like I'm actually in this area, but I'm not. I'm actually in the Big Nothing. I've gotten here via the Big Nothing by coming all the way around the edge of Jeet's territory there and to there. And it was quite difficult to do, I'm not going to lie, because there's loads of cliffs in this whole area, and some of them are completely unpassable, like there's invisible walls and all sorts. But I finally got here, so let's take a look. Seem to be a few different ways to go, so let's try going clockwise. Sure, do you like their spikes? So that car right there will be our way out in a second. Sure if you're meant to be able to go under there or not, but there it was. I'm going to clear all my ones. Remember which way I came from, to be honest. I think I might have come from over here. No, probably not. Okay, so there's actually multiple ways into this place. This is a totally opposite entrance to the entrance I took to come in. Alright, so it's in and out of the big nothing in the dunes. Yeah, because that's where I came in. This is where I should have come in. I managed to go around the mountains in this area and sort of force my way into the dunes to come in that entrance. So I suppose it's a nice little secret way of getting into the dunes early, should you decide you want to do that. Just come out from the outer graves, go around the big nothing, around here, and in the entrance I just came out. Yeah. where it's parked, it's really handy. It comes out of this pipe. I'll show you, it's really cool. Yeah. If we could start using the ladders instead of falling down them, that would be awesome. Yeah, no wonder you've got a limp. I do believe I came from up here somewhere. You know, I came from this way. And this is that dead end of the maggots. Yeah, okay, cool. So I believe I've explored everywhere in here.
They won't see me coming in this. Not right away.
Okay, and we are now outside in the big nothing. So another interesting thing, what's left of the big wet. A tiny part of the ship. And a guy that was paragliding at some point and died. Because he got stuck on the mast of the ship. I find that quite amusing personally. Now we're gonna go there-ish, I think. Okay, so from this location at the edge of Dry Gusty, we have our road, which we can follow for quite some time, so let's do that. And you'll find that there are a few things that we find along the way. Road becomes more and more actually road-like as we go.
This place, it ain't a place for a car!
Storm, sandstorm is going to attempt to knock us off path, but we're not going to let it. Trees dotted around. Okay. eventually you come out of the sandstorm. It makes a very loud noise. Because it's absolute hardest to keep you off track. Just for reference on the map, we are now there. And it ends about there-ish. Now, next thing I need to find is the developer area, which I know you can find from the road, but I'm not sure of the exact location. So I'll get back to you when I found it.